Guys, Pastor Greg Locke here. I've got to be honest. The way that some kids talk to their parents these days, I'm not sure if it's the kid that needs a butt whooping or the mom and dad that need a butt whooping. I have never heard such disrespect in my life. I've been a parent for a long time and a pastor for a long time. I just picked up my 13-year-old son, and I want you to know that there was this girl. She couldn't have been more than 11 or 12 years old. Stick her long, bony finger through the driver's side of her mother's vehicle, right up to her mother's face, and she said, and I quote, "Well, it's your fault that we're running late. I told you not to park here. If you'd have parked where I told you, then we wouldn't be running late. But I'm still going to the Dollar General store with my friend," and turned and walked away. Had I done that to one of my parents, or especially one of my grandparents, I'll have you know that after I picked my sorry carcass up off the ground, wiped the blood out of my nose, and fixed my teeth, then I would have got a proper whooping. You say, Pastor Locke, somebody would have called DCS on your granddaddy, and he would have whooped them with a paddle and a switch when they showed up as well. Listen, at my house, we call it the golden rule. He that maketh the gold, maketh the rules. You burn my gas, sleep in one of my beds, eat food off my table, put your feet under my table, and take a shower in one of the water units that I pay for, I'll have you know, you're going to do what I say. These kids shake their heads, snap their fingers, bow their back like little banny roosters as the rebels they are and say, "Well, when I'm 18 years old, I'm out." Number one, go ahead and try that, bucko. If you think I'm going to raise some millennialized kid that's going to lay around in my basement till the sun warms their feet till they're 35 years old, you're crazy. Let my kids threaten me with, "When I'm 18, I'm gone." And they can be gone the night before they turn 18. The first time they have to pay an insurance bill, the first time they have to pay a mortgage, they'll come back to mom and daddy's house real, real quick. But let me secondarily say this. Whoever come up with a stupid rule that when you turn 18 years of age, you somehow are an adult and you can live the way you want to? I'll be honest with you. I didn't even understand what life was about till I was 30 years old. 18 years old and you're an adult. 18 years old, you ought to still be wearing diapers. Have you lost your ever-loving mind? And the way these kids are talking to these parents these days, it ought to be spoken from the pulpit. It ought to be spoken politically. And parents ought to stand up to their kids. You had the kid. You support and pay for the kid. And you let that trash mouth run you down in your house. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Let them sleep out back in the doghouse with the bulldogs for a couple of days and see what they think about that. Are you kidding me? Have one of my kids talk to me like that. If I caught one of my kids talking to my wife like that, I would wear their butts out in the front yard and make a viral Facebook video over it. Talk to me like that. Talk to an adult like that. The Bible says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right." It's the first commandment with promise. Let me tell you something. It's not just a parent that ought to whoop your tail. You disrespect an adult, especially a mom or a dad or an elderly person in your life, you better know this. God'll jerk a knot in your tail.